I am really looking forward to watching this movie Into the Spider-Verse. I wonder what it'd be like if I was in the Spider-Verse.
Needless to say, I keep a check. She was a bad, bad, nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place, baby, you're a wreck. Needless to say, I'm keeping a check. She was a bad, bad, nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby.
Batman?
Courtesy of your friendly neighborhood Spider-Bat.
Yeah! Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse is a new film released by Sony, and this film was directed by Bob Prichet, I'm not really good with last names, so you're going to have to forgive me on that one. This film centers around Miles Morales, and after he was bitten by a spider, he finds himself in the middle of a battle between Spider-Man and Kingpin. And there is this machine that Kingpin has created that has the ability to open up portals to different universes. And the machine malfunctioned, and Spider-Man from other universes started to appear. Now Miles Morales has to team up with the other spider people, and they try to stop Kingpin and return back to their respective universes. But I did love the Spider-Man films, and I think that my favorite Spider-Man film of all time is Spider-Man 2. No, I don't think. I know. It is. Spider-Man 2 is the best film of all time. And I believe I have found the second Spider-Man film of all time, and that is Into the Spider-Verse. There's like so many things you can love with this film. I love the animation. The animation is very similar to the Disney Pixar films, but the stylistic choices was just fantastic. And while watching this film, it feels like you're actually reading a comic book, but on the full screen. This technique was perfected beautifully, and it was visually stunning. And those of you who have followed my channel for many years, you know that my favorite visual film of all time is Blade Runner 2049. That's how great the animation was. The performances were spectacular, and all the characters were really interesting, and each character had their moment to shine. There's an introduction with each character. The character sort of introduced himself in more of a stylistic way that really brings more depth to the character, and it also brings humor to the movie. And not only that, each character has like a different introduction when they're introduced, not the very same introduction. And also, it is like scattered in certain parts of the first act. And Jake Johnson is the voice of midlife crisis Peter Parker. He came from a different universe and he just stumbled across Miles Morales. You really get this character is more like a mentor towards Miles Morales. Yes, Peter Parkers is in the film, but the film focuses primarily on Miles Morales. And this film consists of Miles Morales trying to balance his life and get his things together. Throughout this film, he's trying to balance life, trying to balance school, and dealing with the fact that he has Spider-Man powers. Also, he has a strained relationship with his father. He looks up to his uncle more because his uncle supports him in what Miles Morales wants to do. In some aspects, his character is very similar to Peter Parker due to the fact that they're similar in age when they got their powers, but Miles Morales' lifestyle and story is completely different. There were other characters, there was other Spider-Man characters in this film. I don't want to go in full detail of who exactly they are. I'll just leave a picture right here. The writers did a really good job with the story. They did a really good job of perfectly fitting the characters in the film. The story was cohesive and it kept the nuances with each character. The design of each costume of each character looked really good. They really paid attention to each detail. Each Spider character had their own unique style, their own unique personality added to their costume. For example, Miles Morales, he spray painted, you know, the Spider-Man symbol on his suit. The film gave the audience heavy Spider-Man mythology, so if you are like a die-hard Spider-Man fan, you will catch it immediately. It has like tons of Easter eggs and cultural references. Nicolas Cage was the voice of New York Spider-Man, and Nicolas Cage did a really good job of his performance. And Nicolas Cage appeared in Teen Titans Go. He was the voice of Superman. he did a really good job, and Nicolas Cage definitely deserves more work in the DC as a voice actor. The film was very funny, and it was consistent. I was laughing, like, consistently. There wasn't a time where I was, like, you know, where I got a little bored or in between things. I was simultaneously laughing throughout, and I didn't get bored whatsoever. The animation is very fluid, and there are moments in the film whenever a character is thinking, or if a character makes an awkward moment, you will see a yellow box with text appear next to the character as if you're watching a comic book panel. And also, the film really did a really good job of showing the message behind Spider-Man himself. Like, Spider-Man, he goes through so many obstacles, but yet he finds a way to, you know, to manage, and he finds a way to succeed despite of so many failures. And that's one of the things that the film does a really good job of showing, and the film does a really good job of giving that message throughout the film. Really good job. Also, the message behind the character was the driven force of the emotional scenes and the humor, and it was enthralling. Golly. And I also forgot Kingpin's ass. Kingpin was great. I don't really have any flaws in particular. There were a few color errors and a few distorted images when you're watching the movie, but that's because this film was created as a comic book, and in comic books, there are a few color errors and distortion with a character, and when the viewer is, like, watching or looking at the comic book and they're focusing on a certain image, the outside is kind of distorted, and some of the colors has lots of errors in it because it's focusing on a particular image on the screen. It does it on purpose, and I don't know if any person would notice that but me, but I don't know. But that's really a nitpick. I am trying hard right now. So really, I'm going to give Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse and Ben Affleck Batman-tastic. This is the guaranteed one of my favorite films of the year. It is in my top 5 somewhere, so I had to really complete my top 10 list very, 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 very soon. Alright guys, have you seen Into the Spider-Verse? What are your thoughts on the film? And plus, they're making a sequel to this film as well. And if you stay for the end credits, you'll be amazed at what you're going to see. So, what are your thoughts on the film? Please comment below and give me your thoughts, and let's talk about it. Guys, if you like everything you see and you agree, subscribe to my channel and join me in the Batman family. I'll have more Batman-tastic reviews on the way. You have been warned. Till then, ciao.